historic reversibility in public sphere. Nostalgia. Nostalgia is not a passive emotion, but a way to alternative thinking. This concept I borrowed from Svante Boyle's book, The Future of Nostalgia. Early Zionist propaganda films, a commitment to the national revival. During the early 20th century, Zionist films were produced by the Jewish National Fund for the sole purpose of promoting the dream of constructing a Jewish state in Palestine. The role of those eyewitness-like films was to serve as a cinematic evidence that a Zionist vision can be indeed materialized. These movies, based both on a true and staged events, were produced in order to prove that the Zionist ideology was indeed constructing a Jewish existence that could solve the problem of the Jewish people and were screened to Jewish audience through Europe.
Light onto the surrounding wilderness. This new settlement will broaden the base of Palestine's economy. It will assure a creative future for the young members of this estate. And with its development, it will offer a haven for the many young Jews outside Palestine, whose only future at present lies in the dark cell of the concentration camp, or the hard, cruel road of the wandering refugee. Here they will live and work in freedom, flashing out like the light from this watchtower, a beam of progress in the wilderness.
Wall and Tower, Choma Migdal in Hebrew. The Wall and Tower project took place during the 1936 to 1939 in Palestine, a period of the Arab revolt against mass Jewish immigration to the land. The uprising against the British mandate and the increasing Jewish immigration triggered the Jewish European settlers to embark on operation declaring a new territorial reality through the expansion of Jewish settlement in Palestine. Through well-planned and quick operation, more than 57 settlements were constructed, some of which were built overnight. Operation Wall and Tower redefined Jewish possession of land throughout Palestine and served until the very day a constitutive Zionist ethos. Picture this. A chapter in European history book will be dedicated to the return of 3 million Jews to Poland. Marek Koszmary, Nightmares, a Polish trilogy. For this project, I created the Jewish Renaissance Movement in Poland. It is a collaboration with the Polish left activist Sławek Szarakowski and MoMA Warsaw. Its aim is to think and rethink the Polish-Jewish drama to overcome the Israeli and Polish guilt and the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, and to propose utopian visions of homecoming. It is not a realistic movement, but rather one that seeks to mirror history and present, to question, provoke, and disturb the mainstream Zionist narrative. Szarakowski is an activist from Poland. He's the chief editor of Krytyka Polityczna. That's their meeting room. And the idea was in this project to create the first kibbutz in Warsaw based on the Wall and Tower kibbutz. The kibbutz will be built, and actually was built already, in front of the uprising Warsaw ghetto. I will show now two clips from the first two parts of the trilogy. In the first film, the speech delivered by Szarakowski himself in an empty stadium in Warsaw. On the second clip is a construction of the first kibbutz in Poland on the ground of the former Warsaw ghetto, and in front of this monument.
Żydzi, wracajcie do Polski, do waszego, naszego kraju. Uleczcie nasze rany, a uleczycie swoje. I będziemy znowu razem. To apel, ale nie apel poległ. To apel dla życia. Chcemy, aby do Polski wróciło 3 miliony Żydów i abyście znowu byli z nami, zamieszkali. Potrzebujemy was. Prosimy, wróćcie.